organization seem to want to stay in San Antonio. And for the teams that have been eliminated from the playoffs, Brent, these games don't carry quite the same weight.
But Kevin, the interesting part about that is for the guys who haven't played, they're chomping at the bit to get out there and show the coaches that they might have made contributions to your team's success in the early part of the season. And again, establish some sort of confidence going into the offseason that they come back as better players with more of an opportunity next year to make a difference.
And still showing stuff on tape for other teams in case they're free agents.
No question. If you finish off the season and you finish strong, the consideration from other teams about you joining their roster can increase.
A look at the opening lineup for the Houston Rockets. Beverly and Harden are the one and the two. Ryan Anderson out there with Clint Capella. And it's Ariza in at the small forward position. Back to Beverly. Down low. And the dunk by Capella.
And how about just floating to the rim on that slam?
Boy, when he gets up, I mean, he gets up. Parker kicks to Leonard. And it's Leonard again missing. Well, it was the San Antonio Spurs winning their last game against Memphis.
Ooh!
Okay.
That's how you attack. Wow. Oh, fantastic dunk. And he hangs around up there just for a little camera time.
Yeah, maybe he didn't want to land awkwardly. Who knows? But there he is, and we see it very clearly.
Yeah, and that's what you want from your point guard. Parker distributing the ball wonderfully on that possession. And when you look at the Rockets, I mean, plenty of offense. But last year, there was a huge drop-off defensively. And given this team's lofty goals, that really flies right in the face of that old adage, defense wins championships.
It's good.
Always pushing the action offensively. He puts so much pressure on the defense.
Passes it to Dedmon. There's the feed to Leonard. Right wing. Here's Aldridge. It's rebounded by Houston.
He looked like he was in rhythm to shoot that one, guys, especially as open as he was. Just clanged it.
Over in the corner, Beverly. And the call will be against Tony Parker. That's his first foul. So San Antonio going with an almost entirely new group here. Pau Gasol's checked in for Dwayne Dedmon. Kyle Anderson comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge. Manu Ginobili, he's checked in for Green. And it's Mills in for Tony Parker. And then for Houston, Nene, he's checked in for Clint Capella. Gordon comes in for Trevor Ariza. And it's Williams in for James Harden. They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
Mills dishes to Anderson. Ginobili outside. Shot clock at 6. 13 feet away. It's good on the putback.
And those second chance points really become almost like bonus points when you can get them.
Here is Williams coming off a stellar performance against Oklahoma City. Nene with the screen on Ginobili. With the putback. And it's good, but hold on. The officials may want to look at that one on the replay monitor. And indeed, they're going to look at it again. They need to be certain he beat the buzzer.
Yeah, it's hard to tell on that one. And so a good time to go to the replay and just to make sure if he got it off.
Due to LaMarcus Aldridge's game.
And you know, Kevin, that's what's going to be so interesting to find out. Now, some players, you know, they really relish in that situation. They rise to that occasion. Others, I don't want to say they wilt under the pressure, but they're just not comfortable in that environment. And in the NBA, you get to do it on TV and in front of thousands in person.
And so far, it's been a closely contested game as we get the second quarter up and going. And looking at what we've seen from Houston, what do you guys think?
A lot of tough D being played by them so far. It's been the difference maker.
Very physical, very active. Their defense has all the components needed to get stops.
In a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. On the court for San Antonio. Mills out there with Simmons. Then there's Anderson. Then it's David Lee. And it's Gasol. And at the 5, down low.
Well, Eric Gordon coming off that big contract, which ended last season. Injuries have just plagued his entire career. Still trying to find a season where he can play all 82 games.
Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sidelines.
Well, guys, we know Greg Popovich uses a lot of different tools to motivate his players. Sometimes it's the things he doesn't say that works best. Popovich said, sometimes in timeouts, I'll say, I've got nothing for you. We just turned it over six times. Everybody's holding the ball. What do you want me to do? Figure it out. Now get up and walk away. Because it's true. It's on them. Kevin?
Thanks, D.A. That accountability goes a long way.
Yeah, it looks like he got to that shot just after it reached its apex. Those can be tough ones to gauge.
Green, he's checked in for the Spurs. Parker comes in for Patty Mills. And a change for the Rockets. Clint Capella, he's checked in for Williams. Gasol passes to Simmons. Nice ball movement by San Antonio. It's Gasol missing. And Eric Gordon, a good outside shooter. Not quite as explosive as he once was, though, getting to the rim.
Yeah, I agree with you there, Kevin. He's lost a little bit of that burst. Of course, at 6'4", he gives up a little bit of height at the shooting guard position, but still effective in scoring the ball.
Here's Harden. Doesn't go that time. Excellent D there from Parker. And Simmons kicks to Green. He feeds it to Parker. On the wing, Lee. Baseline try. And it's good on the assist by Parker.
You gotta love the effort from Parker, constantly helping get his teammates involved.
Now here's Gordon. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Harden outside. And a pretty tightly contested game here as we end the first half. Some boats and nightclubs and people. What's going on? And now the start of the second half. Neither side jumping out ahead through the first two quarters. And on the floor for Mike D'Antoni starting the second half. Harden and Ariza, the athletic wing pair. Clint Capella is out there with Anderson. And it's Beverly in at the one spot.
And when you look at the Spurs, it's about the offensive philosophy in terms of ball movement. You look at the numbers, players shoot much more efficiently off of the catch than they do with the dribble. The Spurs exemplify the good to great in ball movement.
Harden has a wide open look. Offline with his three. San Antonio trailing here. Now Parker. He gives his team some nice contributions, averaging a bit over 10 points a game. Here's Leonard. He nails it, and we're tied up. Leonard's got the first basket of the third quarter for San Antonio. And the Spurs offense, just beautiful basketball. They call it good to great. You pass up a good shot to set up your teammate with a great shot.
Well, I think what they do well, Kevin, is always explore what it is they can get to first. If it happens in the first 6 seconds, they'll take advantage of you. And if they don't, they'll get into the half court, run multiple pick and rolls. And every time somebody needs an outlet, there's a guy in the right spot to bail you out on the possession. It's often beautiful to watch.
Parker dishes to Leonard. Back to Parker. And foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot two.
And Parker just so skilled at marching his way to the stripe. He just has an endless amount of cunning moves that consistently frustrate the opposition.
And Tony Parker, the third Frenchman ever to play in the NBA, and unquestionably the best.
Well, we've seen a lot of his countrymen follow in his footsteps, and he came over so young. At that time, he was the youngest point guard in the NBA since Magic Johnson was in 1979. And like Magic, he quickly earned some championship hardware.
Here's what San Antonio's going with right now. Pau Gasol's checked in for Dwayne Dedman, and it's Ginobili in for Daniel Green.
Well, if Eric Gordon gets the ball from beyond the arc, you have to respect his ability to knock those down.
Leonard with the bucket.
Oh, and he likes the mid-range, Jay. You have to get right up on him if you want to stop it.
And Beverly kicks to Williams. Left side, Gordon. Again, the miss by Gordon. Clock management. This is where they can get a two for one.
And Kevin, every opportunity counts.
Houston's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Gasol with the steal. In transition, here come the Spurs. Parker's running. Count that bucket. And the Spurs lead by two.
And offensively, they seem to have turned a corner.
And here is Williams. He's been putting up the points on a very steady basis, averaging around 17.5 points a game. With one on the clock, that misses, would have counted had it gone in.
That is pure Manu there, aggressive and relentless, in particular on the defensive end.
It's still anybody's game as we've reached the end of three. It's the Spurs. They're up by two. And when we return, we'll get the fourth quarter as we welcome you back. The fourth quarter of action getting started. The Rockets shooting just 35%. They've got to get better looks. Mills teams up with Green in the backcourt. Kawhi Leonard is out there with Anderson. And it's Deadman in at the five. That's the San Antonio five. And now it's Green running. He can go all the way. And Mills kicks to Anderson.
Yeah, good job to take it right at the D.
First one falls for, and the Rockets making a change here. Harden's checked in. And both free throws good for Anderson. Rockets trail by four. Harden outside to the paint. Ariza, and it's good. Bump through
good.
Contact. It's
good.
The shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
And this has really been a well-played game up to this point. And you know what? I bet it stays that way until the end.
And how can we know? It comes down to one team's will against the others.
One shot.
On the free throw, no good. And San Antonio shooting from the field, 44%, not bad. Leonard kicks to Deadman. Green, the screen, and the pass to Anderson. Mills loses his man off the screen and lays it up and in. Mills has got the lead up to four now for the Spurs. Mills has gone 2 of 4 from the field. Here's Harden. Sweet little floater.
I like that. Didn't force the jam, just happy to lay in the soft floater.
Just over a minute played here in the fourth. Mills passes to Deadman. Wide open. Mills can't hit.
Not quite sure why he felt the need to rush that one. He had all the time in the world and just threw it up before he was ready to go.
Anderson the screen. Harden dishes to Beverly. To the inside. Here's Nene, and it goes as the official calls the foul. Count it. He'll shoot one more at the free throw line. Marcus Aldridge has checked in for San Antonio. Parker comes in for Patty Mills. Nene, no good on the free throw. 1:24 left to play in the final quarter. And it's Green missing.
And you know what? That's one of those heat checks if he's taking shots like that.
And even though he's been on a roll tonight, that one was a bit forced.
And here's Anderson for three. He can't hit that time. For San Antonio, they've gone 1 of 3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. Nobody near Leonard. Buries the triple.
Man, I'll tell you what. The pressure is cranked up. Who better to call than this guy?
Harden outside. There's the dish to Beverly. Five on the clock. Pass to Nene. Ariza kicks to Harden. That shot missing. And the Spurs going the other way now. They'll be trying to take as much time off the clock as they can.
Exactly. Expect to see longer possessions from this point on. And Parker just so smart about knowing when to take three-pointers. A lot of confidence from him there, sinking the outside shot.
Now, here's Capella. D right on him. Deep two from Anderson. And the shot no good, a bit short. And that's an intentional foul. Thank you. 15 seconds left to play here in the fourth, and now they decide to foul intentionally. Good on the first, and that makes it a 7-point lead. And so he drops them both. It's an 8-point game. Timeout called. The Rockets, they trail by 8. There's 14 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Guys, your thoughts?
You know, I think he's just trying to send his team a message, you know, not willing to give up on this game just yet. Just trying to instill that fight in this group.
Well, you still can't control the outcome, only playing your hardest moment to moment. That's what he's getting through to them now.
The screen from Brown. Here's Gordon. Good. Great play by Williams to set it up.
Great finish from Gordon in traffic. You like to see the smaller guys operate down low as long as they're patient.
And so it's San Antonio with the win. It was a fantastic ball game, and they did a great job making sure it didn't get away from them late.
Yeah, I mean, they faced some challenges, but really helped.
Thanks very much, pal. Congrats on the win. Big performance defensively tonight. How important is that to your success?
Well, defense got to be always our motor. If we get some stops, we're doing a good job defensively, everything will be okay from that point on. So we just got to continue to emphasize our defense.
I know you work on that a lot in practice, and it showed tonight, pal. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David. It was both very tough on the glass.
Oh, yeah. High effort, high energy. They sharpened their elbows for this one. It's an inside battle.
Yes. A look at the opening lineup for the Houston Rockets. Beverly and Harden are the one and the two. Clint Capella is out there with Anderson. And it's Ariza in at the three. And it's Beverly missing. On defense, Houston. They want to keep rolling here following the win against the Thunder.
And after that game, it was impressive to look at the box score and see the work they did at the free throw line.
Well, they dictated the pace, and the defense was a half step slow, adjusting most of the night.
Anderson the screen. Beverly dishes to Harden. And a big bounce off the rim, but it sinks right in.
Just phenomenal awareness by Beverly, just dishing the ball to the wide open man easily.
Parker kicks to Leonard. Doesn't go that time. Good D by Ariza. So it's the Rockets now. Victory eluded them last time in San Antonio when they took on the Spurs.
They played well enough to win that game. It really could have gone either way.
Yeah, though it could be a learning opportunity for them. Failed to execute on just a few key plays. It could have been a difference to put them over the top.
The Spurs shooting their first free throws here tonight.
And how about as a group, 80% on the season, one of their best attributes.
And that's good as he hits both of his shots.
Well, going into the 2011 draft, the Spurs said it was a tough decision to trade away George Hill in exchange for the pick that became Kawhi Leonard. No remorse on that one now, though. Once again, the Spurs struck gold as Kawhi has developed into a true superstar.
And so it looks like the Rockets will retain possession here.
And really, no choice but to lunge for that pass to make sure it didn't get through.
Oh, great resolve there on defense, allowing nothing easy.
Now, here's Beverly. He picked up 15 points in their last win against Oklahoma City.
Yeah, but I also thought the rebounding was impressive. He got some huge boards in that game.
It's tipped. The Rockets have gone 1 of 3 from the field to start this one so far. Now the pass to Capella. Anderson the screen. Here's Ariza. Another miss by Houston. Outside, Green. Spurs working the ball around now. Aldridge, good.
And he's starting to get what he wants here early and often. Nice move.
Oh, this could be an early sign of an explosive game for him. You have to keep your eye on him if you're the defense.
And the call will be against LaMarcus Aldridge. That's his first foul.
I like the call. I thought the defense was just there a little late.
Here's what San Antonio's going with right now. Pau Gasol's checked in for Dwayne Dedman. Anderson comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge. Manu Ginobili's checked in for Green. And it's Mills in for Parker. Just 5 on the clock. Williams for 3. Another miss by Houston. Spurs leading by four. Leonard, the pass to Mills. There's the pick. There's 14 seconds left in the first quarter. Here's Leonard, takes it into the teeth of the D and converts the layup.
Heads up, aggressive move. The smaller man on him takes him right to the rim.
I'm open!
For three, Williams, no good, shot missing. And the two of them, sons of medical professionals in Spain, have become two of the best centers in the NBA of this era.
Especially when you remember what a raw talent and how big and bulky Marc Gasol was when he was drafted by the Lakers. I mean, they traded him to Memphis for his brother. And that does all seem like fiction, doesn't it?
All right, the second quarter beginning in just a moment. And taking a look at San Antonio's performance here. What do you think they've been doing or not doing?
Defense paying huge dividends for them through the first.
You're right. They've been extremely active, physical, really dictating the flow of this game.
And a chance here presented by Gatorade to see who's on the floor, all fueled up and ready to go for the start of the second quarter. So on the floor for Houston, they've got Trevor Ariza, Harden out there with Williams. Then there's Nene, and it's Gordon in at the small forward. On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, guys, Greg Popovich has set the standard with more than 1,500 career victories. Last season, he set the record with his 18th 50-win season, passing Pat Riley and Phil Jackson. Pop told us that, "I've been here a long time, and I've had good players. That's the formula. Getting the players is difficult. I've been fortunate to have good ones." Guys, he's no glory hound. He knows what makes success.
No, but he can take a lot of the credit regardless, D.A., thanks. Now, here is Harden. He's coming off a 34-point game against Oklahoma City.
Kev, whenever I see Trevor Ariza out there, I can't help but think of how he came into the spotlight. He went from being a role player early to becoming a major part of teams after his stint with the Lakers. He said he learned a lot from playing with Kobe.
Rockets trail by six. Harden outside. Shoots from the line. That one falls. And with Ariza, part of his progression was natural. But he knows that he made a huge jump after he played with Kobe in L.A.
Well, I thought his quote about playing against Kobe was great. I mean, he said, "The first time I played against Kobe, he scored 40 on me. The last time I guarded him, he scored 35. So I guess I got a little bit better." You know what? Great sense of humor. I'm just glad to see you.
And the Spurs with some changes. LaMarcus Aldridge comes in for Lee. And Tony Parker subbed in for Patty Mills. And for those of you just joining us, we're almost 2.5 minutes into the second quarter. And the call will be against LaMarcus Aldridge. That'll be his second foul of the game.
Not good. He already has two early fouls here, and he has to watch himself for the rest of the half.
Here's what San Antonio's going with right now. Dwayne Dedmon's checked in for Gasol. Leonard comes in for Green, and it's Ginobili in for Jonathan Simmons. Houston also making some changes. Anderson, he's checked in for Nene. Williams comes in for Trevor Ariza. And it's Patrick Beverley in for James Harden. Now here's Leonard. A 29-point game for him in the win against Memphis.
And a gigantic game for him at the free throw line. He was an instigator, drawing a ton of contact and really just hunting for the whistle.
And a pretty tightly contested. The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. Spurs leading by four.
And the continuity for the Spurs, really, it's pretty amazing. I mean, that trio of Parker, Ginobili, and Duncan, the most successful trio in the history of the NBA.
Parker and Green, the tried and tested backcourt. Leonard and Aldridge, the two stars at the three and the four. And it's Dedmon in at the five spot. So that's who Greg Popovich starts the second half with.
What about the vision of Ariza just slashing the D apart with his passing?
And for the Spurs, their star players have all taken less, Greg, in free agency in order to stay in San Antonio.
Yes, burning bigger markets and bigger paychecks. It's a family atmosphere in the Spurs organization. It's rare to see a single player start and finish his career with one team, much less three teams.
And how about that, responding to the three-pointer against them with a quick one of their own?
I like that style. Lose 3 points, get them right back at the other end. That's good basketball.
San Antonio leading. Outside Leonard. Parker outside. Back to Leonard. Tries to save it. And it's good. Walk through contact. It's the shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
Yeah, starting the second half nicely there. Love those easy lay-ins to get things going.
It's a nice momentum builder coming out of halftime for sure.
Here's what San Antonio's going with right now. Pau Gasol is checked in for Dwayne Dedman. Kyle Anderson comes in for LaMarcus Aldridge. Simmons checked in for Daniel Green. And it's Mills in for Parker. Now, here is Harden. His offensive numbers jump right off the screen. He was averaging over 29 points a game.
And a crafty pass into the lane, perfectly executed. Harden can carry an offense alone with his scoring. That's no secret. A big part of why he's able to do that is because he's so gifted at getting to the line. The past couple of years, he's averaged more than 10 free throw attempts a game.
And on our sideline, our reporter, David Aldridge.
Well, Kawhi Leonard keeps getting better year after year. The 2014 Finals MVP said, "I'm very confident with where I'm at. Every time I step on the floor now, I know I can be a factor. Offensively, defensively, shooting threes, working my way into the post, setting other guys up. Kevin, he can do it all."
He's grown into that role of franchise player, DA. Great stuff. Thank you. And however you feel about Harden getting to the line, whether you think he deserves it or oversells calls, you can't deny, Chris, that he is effective doing it.
Well, some may say it's a lot easier to shoulder an offensive load at the free throw line, but they may never have taken the physical beating that it takes to get to that line. You got to give Harden credit. He knows how to create contact and push the issue. Very crafty when he goes up for a shot if he feels a defender is caught with his hand in the cookie jar. In other words, reaching in for the ball.
The third quarter comes to a close. A chance now to hear Greg Popovich talking to his team just moments.
This game is a big boy.
The fourth quarter just moments away now as we welcome you back. Rockets trail by 7, so on the floor for Houston. Clint Capella is out there with Ryan Anderson. Then it's Williams. Then it's Patrick Beverley. And it's Gordon in at the 3 slot. Ginobili against Williams. Just 4 to shoot. Takes the 13-footer. No good that time. Nice D from Ginobili.
And they're controlling the boards, Kevin. That's plus 5 in that category.
Kicks it to Aldridge. Back to Ginobili. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a 3-point play.
How about that one? Able to maintain control and finish the play.
That free throw good from Ginobili. Rockets trail by 10. Outside Williams. And he gets the friendly spin, and that one drops.
And really smart to draw his man out to the perimeter. He's giving up too much size to be effective inside.
Isn't that when you use your other skills like your mindset? That's just a high basketball IQ play right there. He knew he was no match inside. So what did he do? He pulled his defender out farther from the hoop.
Love the aggressive attitude. I mean, no invitation needed for him to take it strong to the basket.
Now a timeout called by Houston. They're down by 10. We've got 1:55 left in the fourth quarter. San Antonio making a switch here. Green's checked in. And we've got an update here, so let's check in with David Aldridge reporting from the sideline.
Kevin, I was able to listen in on what Mike D'Antoni was talking about with his team. He said, "Guys, we need to play with pace, and that'll get us some early fast break opportunities. We're playing way too predictable right now." Guys.
And Capella sends it back. Aldridge dishes to Leonard. 6 to shoot. second chance effort. They grab their own miss, and it's good, 2 points. And the Spurs lead by 12.
They have got to box out better than that. That putback's just another example of what a difference there's been between these two teams.
I mean, it just goes to show the lack of effort on their part. Their opponents simply want this game more than them right now.
Good on the three-point shot.
You see what I'm saying? It's that kind of unfair advantage. At this height, to shoot over guys that well from that deep, that's just sick.
Parker kicks to Leonard. There's the pick. Launches a three. Another miss by Leonard.
And with room like that off the pick, you have got to knock that one down.
Well, the screen got him all the space he needed to release that one. I thought for sure that was going in.
And it's Gordon missing.
Great-looking defense, really, just to disrupt the rhythm on that shot.
They made that possession super uncomfortable. And as a result, they got the stop they needed.
Here's Leonard, gets the 14-footer to fall.
Well, they're going to walk out of here with a win and send this crowd home happy.
Well, they have to be pleased with their play here today, and you can bet the fans are pumped as well.
And it's Capella missing. San Antonio with the ball. Leonard, the pass to Green. And so it's San Antonio, easily taking this one. Some good moments throughout this one, but they have the clear advantage down the stretch.
Yeah, I mean, I love the way they executed on both ends of the floor, completely under control for the vast majority of the game. And whenever there was a misstep, they just didn't allow it to fester, and that's why they're going to walk away with the win.
And that about does it for the final game of the NBA regular season. For Chris Webber, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is...